amigos, una nueva edición de Auto 060 y hoy vamos a tener un show muy especial. Vamos a dedicar la hora entera a un solo evento de los muchos a los que asistimos durante todo el año, pero este es un evento muy especial. Se trata del evento Nissan 360. Este es la reunión que hace el fabricante japonés de todos los vehículos que fabrica alrededor del mundo, en todas sus plantas, en Japón, en Tailandia, en México, en Europa, y hace la presentación de todos los nuevos modelos, las nuevas tecnologías, y una reunión muy interesante también con colegas de otros países. Así que vamos a escuchar primero a Víctor Nassif, que es uno de los directores de comunicación global de Nissan. Es un mexicano basado en Londres y tiene mucha información al respecto. Después, en los siguientes segmentos, vamos a hablar con diseñadores, con ingenieros. Vamos a hablar también con una de las pilotos de pruebas de la Nissan y con un colega inglés que vive en Japón y ve la industria automotriz desde la perspectiva desde ese país. Así que vamos aquí con la primera entrevista de Nissan 360 con Víctor Nassif.
Hello, Victor. So here at Nissan 360 in California, this is, I believe, the third edition of this event, right?
It is. We've done it since about 10 years ago was the first one, and then in 2008 was the second one, and now we're having this one in 2013 in Southern California.
Yeah, the past one was in Portugal, I remember, in Estoril. It was a fantastic event. But I have to be honest with you, I'm even more surprised by this one. I mean, it's just the logistics of this event are incredible.
Yeah, we have over 130 cars. Obviously, there's a couple racing cars there. We brought some heritage cars from our collection in Japan. Cars that were shipped over that maybe most of the public and the press have not seen in many, many years. So yes, we've got quite a few.
Okay, so let's talk about Nissan. I mean, why does Nissan do this event? I mean, this is pretty amazing and very unusual. I don't think there's any other manufacturer that does this.
Yeah, we do that for a couple of reasons. One, I think, is internal, to show what we're doing internally on a global scale. So often, some of our team members are involved in regional work, and they're doing a great job there, but this allows a lot of the executives to see the global scope that we have in products that maybe they don't have a chance to drive because it's not part of their region. So that's the first thing. The second thing is that it's great also for the executives and the press to meet. It's more casual, it's more relaxed, it's not a motor show that you go from one brand to another, one company to another. You're actually able to really talk directly to the executives and to understand the philosophy behind Nissan.
Yeah, and the range of vehicles is amazing. I mean, the three brands, Nissan, obviously, Infiniti, and now Datsun that is coming back, right?
Yes.
Some markets, not everywhere.
Yeah, we have Datsun, which is one of my personal favorites. When I grew up in Mexico, we had the Datsun 510, obviously. And the brand is being reintroduced mostly in Thailand and Asian countries, and obviously it'll start in Russia in the not-too-distant future. We have Infiniti, which is growing very quickly. We have new products that are being introduced for Infiniti, and then we have Nissan, which is very, very well known in throughout the world.
Yeah, and within Nissan, I think you kind of separate things for passenger cars and commercial vehicles.
Yeah.
And I don't know, the taxi division is growing pretty quick, so maybe that will be a third one.
Absolutely. I was very fortunate enough to work on a couple of the taxi projects. One, when I was starting here in the United States, they had actually contacted the design, the New York City contacted design first. And so I feel like I was part of that initial group that was getting visibility for the taxi. And then obviously taxis that are being done in other countries.
Yeah,
so that's starting to
expand. The London cab is coming up too, right?
Yeah, yeah. When I was, because I'm based in London, we were working on the taxi. And obviously you're going to see some good news coming out of that in the not too distant future.
Yeah. So, and then the commercial vehicles. I just drove a version, a concept car, I think it's called the NV200 Atlas, which is like a derivative of the Leaf, so an electric commercial vehicle.
Yes, absolutely. That's we see that as a huge potential for people that are driving in the city. They do their deliveries. They're doing not so much in terms of long mileage, but they're spending a lot of time doing their deliveries. We want it to be as efficient and as effective as possible. The other vehicle that I think you should drive is that 30-seater bus that we have out there,
okay,
which not too many people know that we make a bus, in obviously mostly the Asian countries, but it's fantastic to
drive. I already drove that, the Japanese cab with the level for the door. It's pretty cool.
It is.
Let's talk a little bit about things that are happening in Nissan now. Nissan 88, what is that?
Yeah, the Power 88 talks about, the word power is really the brand power. And the 88, the first 8 stands for obviously the market share that we're growing, and the profits. The second 8 is the profits.
So we're hoping 8% of market share globally.
Globally, and 8% profits globally. We're not quite at 8% in the market share yet, but we're heading towards that. Obviously, our objective is to do it by 2016.
Yeah. And within that, to achieve those goals, I mean, a lot of product has to come down the pipe, right? And the base is incredible. I hear like a new car every 6 weeks or something like that?
Yes. Obviously, it's not going to come all of it in one region. It's going to be in different regions.
Yeah, but still.
But we have 51 new products coming out over the next 4 years altogether during this Power 88 initiative. The other thing that happens is the technology. We're going to have 15 new technologies coming out every year between now and then, which, again, it's a combination of new products, new technologies, expanding our market footprint. Those are all the things that are going to help us to achieve Power 88.
Yeah. And speaking of technology, there are a few things that during the presentations here at Nissan 360, I've been hearing about safety and emissions, and the common number is zero. I mean, safety, zero deaths by pretty soon, I mean, within the technology that you guys have?
Yeah, that's what we're aiming for, obviously. We want everybody that drives a Nissan Motor Company vehicle, which is Nissan, Infiniti, or Datsun, to be safe, and to feel safe. And so we want zero fatalities. We also have a huge initiative, as you can imagine, for electric vehicles. That's zero CO2 emissions, which is fantastic, and we're being very socially responsible.
And that's being led by the Leaf, obviously, and other projects, but also in the production part of it, like your plants are becoming more efficient, like the disposal of materials and all those kind of things.
Absolutely.
Right?
So it's not just turning out the car that's efficient, it's also the whole process from the very beginning. How do we become more efficient? How do we show our social responsibilities from even the initial planning stages through the manufacturing, through the sales experience?
Yeah. And the other thing is, we talk about a lot about the Leaf, which is like kind of the star of the company right now. Mm-hmm. But you have another star on the other extreme, the GTR.
Yeah.
That's an amazing. Everybody's like online to drive that one.
Yeah. Well, I always say that. Whenever I talk GTR, I always start off with saying it's my baby GTR. Because I love that car. Not because I designed it or worked in the development of the vehicle, but because I feel so closely associated with that car. When it first came out, I just said, that's it. I have to buy one. And I'm very fortunate.
So you have one?
I bought one.
Wow.
So every time I talk about the car, I'm talking at it.
You know what you're talking about.
Exactly.
Basically.
I'm talking about it from a customer standpoint, too.
Yeah.
Just how happy I am with that car.
And that car is amazing because the technology, the power, the handling and all that. Actually, I've heard that Juan Pablo Montoya, the former Formula One driver and a NASCAR driver now, got one for his birthday a few years ago from his wife, Connie, and he has said that that's the best car he has ever driven. So, I mean, that speaks a lot.
Oh, I can imagine. Obviously, a guy like Juan Pablo Montoya is able to take the car to its limit. I'm not. But I can tell you, as a normal driver, I appreciate its performance, and it's just so awesome. The other day I was driving, actually, it wasn't my own, but it was one of the company cars here. I was driving it around Los Angeles. And a young lady stopped us on the street, and she said, I just love that car. So even the people that haven't driven the car automatically acknowledge how good that car is.
Yeah. And not only how good it is, but it's a super sports car. So
it is.
It's affordable for what you get. I mean, it's like around $100,000, a little more maybe.
Yeah.
But you get a lot of car for that money.
Oh, my goodness, yeah. There's nothing on the road that can beat it.
Yeah, for that price. Because if you go to that kind of performance and power and all that, you're going to spend a lot more money, right?
Yeah, absolutely. About 5 times more.
Okay. One more thing about Nissan. It's a huge company. Most people don't really realize how big it is. How many employees, how many plants, Can you give us a quick overall of the company?
Well, in actuality, I can't even tell you how many employees we have. I know we have quite a few. Obviously, it's split up regionally, and the plants that we have, we're everywhere in the world. So what we try to do is the products that are sold in specific regions are built in those regions. So the cars that are built in the Americas region, most of the percentage is really coming from the cars that are sold and built right there in Mexico, in the United States, and now obviously in Brazil.
Yeah. Speaking of Mexico, this is a fully bilingual show. I know you are from Mexico. You mentioned it before. So, cambió en español un poco acá para la audiencia que no domina completamente el inglés. México es un país muy importante para la Nissan. Ahí tienen dos o tres plantas, ¿no? Cuernavaca, Aguascalientes, me parece, y están ampliando, ¿no?
Sí, absolutamente. Sabemos que México y Nissan son parte de la misma familia, si puedo decir. Somos la compañía número uno en México. Y yo me acuerdo desde niño que tenía un tío que tenía una agencia de Nissan, Nissan, y eso pues siempre me ha
sembró la semilla para llegar a Nissan. ¿Y cómo llegaste tú a Nissan, por cierto?
Pues yo he estado aquí en la compañía desde hace 10 años. Cuando llegué, vine a California, que vine como vicepresidente de Nissan Design America, y ahora estoy trabajando en Europa. He estado trabajando en Londres los últimos 3 años y medio, primero como vicepresidente de Nissan Design Europe, y ahora soy Global Head Product Communications. Entonces toda la comunicación de los productos que estamos haciendo en todas las partes del mundo, parte de mi equipo tiene la responsabilidad de comunicar eso.
Una compañía muy diversa, porque recientemente hablé con tu colega Alfonso Albaiza, un cubano de Miami, que ahora es director global de Infinity de diseño. Así que felicidades. Víctor, muchas gracias por traernos aquí a Nissan 360 primero, por toda esta información de Nissan, y me imagino la audiencia puede buscar nissan.com dependiendo de donde esté en cada país, ¿no? Pero en Estados Unidos, nissanusa.com, tengo entendido, ¿no?
Exactamente, sí.
Bueno, Víctor Nassif, muchas gracias por otra vez por la oportunidad, y estamos hablando pronto, vamos a seguir manejando autos por acá.
Ok, muy bien.
Tenemos 130, gracias. Así que falta mucho. Gracias.
Ok, gracias.
Ya regresamos aquí en Auto 060 con más de Nissan 360 desde California.